So this is my family room. And again, this is not the fanciest furniture, but for a family room, it's nice furniture. They were a free gift about 30 years ago. You can't kill these things. You can dance on them. See how sturdy this is? I got this free from my dad. And I love this table. I've had it for 30 years, and these will outlive me.
Aimee has a beautiful home. It's large, it's spacious, and she has nice furniture in it, but you don't see a lot of extras. You don't see a lot of expensive things.
For furniture in a house like mine of this quality, it would normally cost about $40,000 to $50,000 with all the furniture and accessories and artwork. I spent, I would say, between $3,200 to $3,800 for everything by going to garage sales and estate sales and hotel liquidation, and it just saves you money. There's no need to spend a fortune to look like you have expensive things.
Aimee the Millionaire does not own a state-of-the-art TV.
I don't have a flat-screen TV. I got this lovely big box thing. It's great. What do I need fancy for? Down here, I have a VCR, one of 3 to 4 that I have around the house that I bought at pawn shops because they don't make them anymore. I can get them at the pawn shop for $30 a piece, complete with remote.
I bet it's 12 years old at least.
On the VCR tapes, these are great because you can reuse them over and over and over again until they start going, or the picture goes all wonky on you. So the way I got the house is when my ex-husband and I decided to divorce, he's got a good heart and he insisted that I keep the house because he knew that if I didn't keep the house, I would move into a hovel of a one-bedroom apartment to save money, and he's right.
Aimee won't pay anyone to clean her home, so her ex-husband volunteers to do it for free, saving her $400 a month.
If you could start and do the toilet, that needs it the worst.
Okay.
To work here.
And don't forget to get under the rim, because you miss that a lot.
I'm glad to help her around the house with the cleaning. I do yard work. I drive her to her appointments some once in a while.
This is like free exercise for him. Keeps him in shape. Win, win, win all the way around.
One of the times that I noticed that Aimee was a cheapskate was I came to her house. She asked me, did I want lunch? So I said, sure. She fixed me a tuna fish sandwich. As I'm eating the sandwich, I'm thinking, this is a little fishy. What is this?
Mike, lunch is ready.
And then I looked on the countertop and I noticed there were cat food cans that were empty. And I thought, no, she didn't do this.
Here, I made you some tuna fish.
Oh, great.
No, I don't think Aimee has actually ever fed anyone cat food, but I wouldn't put it past her to try.
Tuna fish for people, 89 cents. Cat food for cats, 59 cents. Mm. I just saved 30 cents.
Mm, that's good.
I get income in a variety of ways. One is managing my rental properties. The other is managing my investments in a brokerage fund. I don't spend money on business travel. I just think it's a total waste of money because it's not something tangible you get to keep. So I like to find ways to avoid paying for it. I have regular business trips to LA, so I drive my car. My car is a 96 Mustang. It's lovely. Some people call it the beast.
And I'm almost afraid to drive with her in it because you don't know if it's going to break down.
Once a month, Aimee drives 4 hours each way to Los Angeles in her 17-year-old car. And while a flight would cost $250, Aimee will only spend $80 on gas and $10 on an oil change.
She has a slight vibration from the steering wheel going at all speeds.
Wow.
Dude. Yeah, you're just completely bald on there.
Wow.
Along with the tires you need, we got the windshield issue, we got the belt issue.
Right.
All these safety issues going on right now, I feel very uncomfortable letting you leave my facility with the car in this shape.
Hey, Mike, this is Aimee. Listen, I need you to come get me at this stupid garage. They say I can't take the car away because it's unsafe on the road, and I gotta get to my business meeting tonight. I'm gonna have my ex-husband come and pick me up, and he's gonna take me to the airport. I'm determined to get to my business meeting tonight. I'm on my way to the airport right now, and I'm gonna bum a ride for free.
Aimee has dated pilots in the past, so she knows her way around airports. She'll try to find a pilot that's got an empty plane or something like that, you know, and entice them to give her a ride.
Although Aimee has lost time at the garage and needs to get to her business meeting in Los Angeles, she is still not willing to pay for other travel options.
Okay, why don't you wait here and let me show you how it's done. Hi there.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you? Are you a pilot?
Yes, I am.
Oh, terrific. Well, I need to get a flight to LA. I'm desperate to get there today because I have a business trip and I need to get a free flight.
Am I tomorrow?
Maybe no, tomorrow. I have to go today.
Maybe tomorrow, but this thing's not going to be ready to go for a couple of days.
I understand.
But you know what?
Is there anybody
might
else?
Be somebody who does. There's a guy out here, you might see him. His name's Mike.
I see a plane, I don't see a person.
It's behind the other airplane.
Okay.
You really can't stick out your thumb and get an airplane ride. Once in a while, they get lucky and they find someone who's headed where they want to go.
Normally, what people would do is just coming out to an airport, they could ask people that are going up and doing test flights or break-in flights. It's just being lucky and being in the right place at the right time.
When I go to these extremes and people see this, I think it annoys a lot of them, but I don't care. It saves money. If you don't understand that, I don't know how to speak to you.
Aimee is one of those types that I think will never change her cheapskate ways because it's just been ingrained into her lifestyle for so long that that's the way she is.
This is how millionaire cheapskates live.
Aimee is a millionaire, but she's still a cheapskate.
By the way, I forgot to ask, but can I get a ride home too?